thick wall, to have clarity is very, very important. Secondly, enlarge your vision. During a very chaotic world, you need to have your vision not only focused on what is in front of you, but what is around you. As the Chinese says, in chaos, there are opportunities. Number three, open up your heart. In today's very disruptive world with technologies advancing every second of the day, human touch is still extremely important, okay, as reflected by all our industry captains. And finally, just to share this with you, at the ELM Graduate School, our oldest learner is 83 years old. He is currently doing his DBA. So for us, lifelong learning is our key motto. So with that, we hope today will not be the end of your learning, but instead it will be the beginning of everyone's learning. Thank you very much and have a good day.
Thank you, Dr. Nicholas. My dear friends, my name is Eric Bryan. I am the director of CareerSense, Help University's Career Development Center, and also a lecturer at the university, and I'll be your master of ceremonies for this morning. A couple of housekeeping announcements. You are encouraged, strongly encouraged, to have your mask on, except for the graduates when you're going up on stage and when you're going to have your photos taken. As soon as the ceremony is done at the end, we invite you to leave the hall as quickly as you can, because there is another ceremony in the afternoon and this room needs to be sanitized. One thing that's very important for all the graduates is, can I invite you to remain seated throughout the event and refrain from leaving the hall to take pictures? We already have a professional photographer to take your beautiful photos and your beautiful faces, so please do not leave the room to take any other pictures. And that also goes to the family members at the back. I know it's also a very exciting time to have your loved ones, your children, up on stage. Kindly try and not take pictures from where you are, because you may be distracting some of the other parents that are seated behind you. We have photographers with us. So thank you very much for that. And finally, my dear friends, this is a joyous occasion, and we want to keep the mood and the spirits high. So graduates, I hope that you will really applaud the success of your friends as they go up to receive their scrolls. So just as they have clapped and applauded you, please kindly do the same for them. And please remain seated after you've received the scroll and celebrate all those who have received the scrolls after you have, right? So thank you for your attention. Our ceremony will begin shortly, sharp at 10 a.m. If you need to use the washrooms, now is a great time to do so. And after that, you know, as it'll pick up quite quickly, and we should end in a couple of hours. We expect about two and a half hours or so, all right? So thank you very much. Enjoy the morning and enjoy the rest of the day as well. You'll hear from me a little bit later. Thank you very much. You can start talking to each other. Yeah, graduates, can we have you seated right now? As we're going to be beginning in 7 minutes. Thank you for coming back on time. True to fashion with some of our students here, I said toilet break, but some of you went for coffee. Well, welcome back. Thank you for coming back on time. We still have a few. Ladies and gentlemen, HELP University graduates, can I invite you to please stand as we welcome the academic procession. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, can I invite you to please remain standing as we join in the singing of the Nagara Coup. Thank you, and please be seated. Yang Bahagia Datuk Paul Leong, Chancellor, Help University. Yang Bahagia Datuk Dr. Paul Chan, Vice Chancellor and President, Help University. Datin Chan Lau Kam Yok, Group CEO and Co-Founder of Help University. Dr. Kung Kim Hung, Deputy Vice Chancellor for Academic, Help University. Dr. Zakaria Ahmad, Deputy Vice Chancellor for Research, Help University. Dr. Andy Liu, Deputy Vice Chancellor, Help University. Dr. Gerard Lewis, Pro Vice Chancellor, Help University. Dr. Goh Chi Leong, Deputy Group CEO, Help University. Ladies and gentlemen, graduates, Salam Sejahtera and welcome to the 33rd Help University's convocation ceremony. Dear graduates, the long wait is finally here. You have anticipated long enough for this day to come, and congratulations, you made it. Welcome to your convocation ceremony. Together with your families and friends, we at Help, who have shared in your educational journey, we are very proud of you. To begin our ceremony today, it gives me great pleasure to welcome our Chancellor, Dr. Paul Leong, to formally welcome us and to deliver the opening address. Can you all join me in welcoming Dr. Paul Leong?
This is my last convocation address. I thank the co-founders, the University Council, academics, and management for their support for me as Chancellor of Help University for 11 years. Henceforth, I shall always cherish this very rare honor accorded to me. Chief Executive Officer, co-founders, academics, proud parents, dear graduates, ladies and gentlemen, Selamat pagi. 大家早上好, Kalai Vanakam, good morning. I welcome you to our 33rd convocation ceremony. Dear graduates, I'm delighted to announce that all of you have accomplished your degrees. 祝贺你们, Wauduga, and congratulations. Today is indeed your day. It is the day of academic acknowledgement, a day of public recognition, a day of personal pride, and certainly, a day of joy and celebration. In fact, today is the unforgettable beginning of your career journey. Dear graduates, you are fortunate to be guiding at a time of great opportunities and much positivity. You have all experienced an unforgettable period of your lives by attending university where you have received a high quality education to prepare you to take place in society. You have been armed with academic skills and embrace with humanity as well as leadership. Use all this knowledge to learn, unlearn, and relearn for self-improvement in your careers. Despite the current global depressed economic environments, Malaysia's GDP growth hit a 22-year round, a record high of 8.7% against 3.1% for 2021 and minus 5.8% for 2020. This was the highest among all ASEAN countries. Dear graduates, on the other hand, you are also experiencing the effects of turbulent times, which are fraught with tension, economic, media, and financial wars, damaging climate changes, and politics that thrived on popularism, unilateralism, protectionism, sanction, and the disruption of certain global supply chains. Yet, during these difficult and turbulent times, we see sharp divisions, conflicts, confrontations, unilateral sanctions, destructive actions, and proxy war in many parts of the world. Let me briefly highlight to you a few current issues of geopolitical and global affairs and their ramifications and repercussions on the world. The miraculous rise of China within an incredible and unprecedented 40-year period, coupled with its leading position in certain advanced high-tech areas, generate deep envies from some other countries. Recently, China has lifted its 3-year zero COVID-19 policy. Its 2023 GDP is expected to reach a satisfactory level of 5.5 to 6% against 3.1% for 2022, and will continue to act as an efficient engine for the global economic growth. Global economies and organizations even project that China's GDP growth will exceed that of the United States in less than 10 years. I think I'm mentioning the GDP rather than GDP growth. China wants to cooperate with the US, not to confront it. Apparently, China's admirable progress and development have caused anxiety, fear, and insecurity from the Americans, who perceive that the rise of China threatens to replace the US as the world power. For that, the US has unleashed its actions to encircle, confront, and contain China. Time marches on, causing dramatic changes in the world. Hegemony is no longer a divine right. The world's power are best not to be caught in Thucydides' trap. As in modern war, there are no winners, but severe losers. They can seek for workable cooperation based on mutual respect, equal treatment, and win-win advantages. Or else, the world will be confronted with the prospect of another war, which may have more devastating and far-reaching consequences. The Ukraine crisis began about 1 year ago. This war has had far-reaching consequences. It had resulted in a decline in living standards and quality of life for Europeans. The war has also caused a flight of capital away from Europe and a depreciation of the euro dollars, precipitating a rise in living costs and aggravating unemployment problems there. This conflict has divided opinion and invites us to reflect on which side is right. One, despite numerous objections and warnings from Russia over years, NATO pushes its further eastern expansion towards Russian border by wanting to accept Ukraine as its member. And two, Russian invasion of Ukraine is illegal under the international law. Although Russia calls it special military operations. Either way, the preventable war is fraught with great danger and may involve the use of nuclear powers. Dear graduates, the widespread global COVID-19 pandemic has caused the astounding suffering of people, a massive rise in government expenses, deficits, and debt in the world. As of 29 January 2023, there are 670 million infected cases, and the virus has killed 6.8 million people. With the introduction of vaccines for treatment, this virus is placed under control. But there are also side effects coming to light, which needs our scrutiny. And hence, certain crucial, critical, and pertinent questions are still remained unanswered. They are, one, is COVID a lab manufacturing virus? Two, where is its source of origin? And three, what are the side effects and long-term effects of these vaccines? These are important and necessary questions that every person has the right to be told of the truth. Dear graduates, I have highlighted the current three major issues of geopolitical and global affairs to you. Here, I have to add that I stand before you today not to celebrate the phenomenal progress that China has achieved, nor to criticize Western liberalism and free-willing capitalism, but rather to point to you the realities of our time. I wish that the primacy of human intellect and good sense will prevail to avoid a major catastrophe. I am encouraged by positive and constructive saying of former U.S. Secretary of State, Condoleezza Rice, and quote, "Let's cooperate where we can. Let's compete where we must. Let's have differences where we must. But let's try to do it in a way that makes the world safer and more prosperous," unquote. In fact, what the world needs are peace, not war, unity, not division, cooperation, not confrontation, construction, not destruction, progression, not regression, and love, not hatred. Whatever the emerging situation may be, these global events and trends will impact your lives and affect your futures. But with a quality education from help, I'm confident that you will prevail and succeed in your endeavors. Dear graduates, here I would like to remind you that in this digital era, you are the most powerful generation in human history, as you have been armed with the most amazing technology, previously unimaginable, literally at your fingertips. You are able to use these technological tools to source endless news, information, ideas, and specific knowledge immediately, thus helping you to be more learned, creative, and visionary. You can use them to shape and reshape the world, something no previous generation possessed. Furthermore, you are blessed for living in an inherited environment with great opportunities and advantages for your career advancement. Malaysia is rich in primary commodities, especially oil, gas, and palm oil. And being located in the center of a dynamic and progressive region of Asia, and being surrounded by progressive and prosperous ASEAN countries. In addition, Malaysians being good natured and sociable people, and being fluent in major languages, namely Bahasa Malaysia, Bahasa Indonesia, English, and Chinese, are enable us to adapt with ease to different cultures and working environments in the world. These skills come naturally to us as we have grown up in a multiracial, multilingual, multireligious, and multicultural country. Advantage in today's globalized and borderless world. But for me, the most important inherited advantages that we have is our invaluable ancient culture, which, amongst others, places great emphasis on quality education. Malaysian parents uphold the age-old conviction that quality education will enable their children to pursue the successful and satisfying careers, seek a brighter future, and contribute effectively to the advancement of our society. For that, they work hard and are willing to make sacrifices for their children's education. Give a big applause to our beloved parents sitting at the back of the hall. Our young generation must not let your luck and fortunes slip away. It is your duty and responsibility to uphold the country's ongoing political and economic stability. It is time for all of us to revert to a system that emphasizes on racial harmony and respect, high education standards, and increased productivity, transparent and efficient governance, accountability, and care for the welfare of all Malaysians. Having said all this, it's time for me to focus on today's convocation. At this convocation, I'm delighted to announce that HAAP University is conferring the degree of Doctor of Education honoris causa to Dr. Shyam Heng King in recognition of her distinguished services rendered in the education industry and nation. This year, there are 1,122 graduates, comprising 117 graduates with postgraduate degrees and 1,005 graduates with undergraduate degrees. 62.3% of you are female. And 21.1% of you are international students. And 3.2% of the international students are postgraduates. Once again, I congratulate all of you on your graduation. In particular, I congratulate the winners of our Chancellor and President's Awards for their excellent academic performance. Now, I venture to rekindle your emotions if possible and energize your pride, joy, and happiness by announcing your academic achievements and your department's achievement. The Tan Sri Datuk Paduka Dr. Hajar Saliha Outstanding Achievement Award winner is Ms. Nga Ji-en from the Department of Psychology. Stand up if you are here. The President's Award winners are Ms. Lee Shuen from the Department of Psychology. Mr. Dasha Naito Shamamugam from the Department of Law. Ms. Jessie Lok Yen Leng from the School of Information and Communication Technology. Ms. Tam Cheng Leng from the Department of University of London International Programs. Mr. Lee Jun Siang from the Department of University of Derby. Mr. Lo Xing Ying from the Department of Business Studies. Ms. Dai Xing Ying from the Department of Business Studies. Ms. Go Xin Tong from the Department of Accounting and Finance. And Ms. Chia Xiu Feng from the Department of Communication. I just cannot help but notice that only 37.7% of the total postgraduates and undergraduates, and only 30% of the Chancellor and President's Award winners are males. This trend runs directly opposite to the existing huge percentage of male leaders in the public and private sectors. Perhaps the Department of Psychology may give us some analysis over this. For me, my instantaneous reaction to this is perhaps we are the late bloomers in life. I congratulate 73 of you who have received the first class honors results, representing ...7.3% of our total undergraduates. I also congratulate the following seven departments for having produced first class honors graduates this year. Department of Law, 13 graduates. Representing 76.5% of its total graduates. Department of Management Studies, 7 first class honors graduates. Representing 18.4% of its total graduates. School of Information and Communication Technology, 5 first class honors graduates. Representing 15.6% of its total graduates. Department of University of London Programs, 2 graduates. Representing 15.4% of its total graduates. Department of Communication, 6 graduates, representing 14% of its total graduates. Department of Psychology, 29 graduates, representing 11.2% of its total graduates. Department of Business Studies, 11 graduates, representing 2.5% of his total graduates. My congratulations to the Department of Law for its excellent achievement rate. Though number of its graduates is rather low. For that, I also extend my congratulations to the Department of Psychology for producing the highest number of first-class honors graduates. Sometimes statistical data can be very confusing. Again, I congratulate all of you on your graduation. In particular, I congratulate those of you who have done extremely well by winning the Chancellor Award and the President's Award, as well as those who have achieved the first class honors degree. As your Chancellor, to honor all these remarkable, knowledgeable, and excellently motivated young people is always very special to me, as it relates to commitment, passion, excellence, and accomplishment. I thank our academics for their dedication, subject expertise, tutoring, and mentoring throughout your studies. Give them a loud applause. Last but not the least, I convey my profound appreciation to our co-founders for their dedication and commitment in making HELP an impressive, progressive, and innovative university. Dear graduates, the university has duly provided you with academic and character education throughout your studies. We at HELP firmly believe that all these students will guide you to think logically and act responsibly, thus paving the path for you to achieve material, social, intellectual, and spiritual wealth in your careers. Do not be afraid to make a career change should you be unhappy with your work. You are at the age when you still can explore opportunities while chasing your dreams. You may want to wander and old wisdom to gain inspiration for advancement in your careers. George Bernard Shaw once said, quote, "Some men see things as they are and ask why. Others dream things that never were and ask why not." Once you have overcome this imaginative deficit, many problems can be solved. For our international graduates, I hope you have a productive learning experience in Malaysia, and that you will use your network of fellow graduates and friends, both Malaysians and others, for mutual benefit and career advancement. I firmly believe that all of you have the resources and the capabilities to bring about positive change to yourselves, the community, the nation, and even the world. Undoubtedly, you will add meaning, purpose, and fulfillment to your lives. My dear graduates, the future is what you make of it. Much is expected of you. Make us proud. In conclusion, I leave you with my parting words. Be brave and bold to chase for your dreams. And at the same time, also be resolute and persevere to realize them. Teruskan marah dengan tegak dan keberanian demi mengejar impian Anda. Ingatlah untuk sentiasa mengukuhkan tegak dengan penuh ketabahan untuk merealisasikan impian tersebut. Masa depan Anda adalah hasil daripada nukilan dan usaha Anda. Kejayaan Anda adalah kebanggaan kami. Terima kasih. Yongkan zui meng, tong shi xia ding jue xin, juan ci bu jue de qu shi xian ta. Wei lai shi you ni meng chuang jiao de. Yang wo men wei ci gan dao zhi ao. Xie xie ni men de zhi shi. This is going to be the most difficult part. Wana gam. Ongga kanaru gale adanya. Dari yamun. Duni calun dewe. Ate nerahte uruti udang. Widaya muyaji udan, saya batuka. Ongka isi kalum, ongka kerir. Ingale perume pada tuka nandri. Pardon my Tamil pronunciation. My dear new graduates, my very best wishes for your health, happiness, and future careers. Sekian, terima kasih.
Thank you, Chancellor Dr. Paul Leong. Thank you for your advice, counsel, and guidance over all these years. We truly appreciate you as Chancellor. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, as mentioned by the Chancellor, Help University today confers the Honorary Doctor of Education, honoris causa, to Dato Dr. Chiam Heng King. And to introduce Dato Dr. Chiam to all of us, can I kindly invite our Vice Chancellor, Dato Dr. Paul Chan, to give us a citation on Dato Dr. Chiam.
Chancellor, fellow academics, I'm given the honor to read the citation on Dato Dr. Cham Heng King. Datuk Dr. Cham was professor of social psychology in education at the University of Malaya. She is recognized nationally and internationally as the foremost authority on early child care and education in Malaysia. She has many firsts in her early childhood initiatives. Dr. Cham was the founder of the bachelor's and master's program in early child education at the University of Malaya, the first of their kind in the country. She spearheaded and worked with the Malaysian Qualifications Agency to develop standards for professional early childhood programs at all levels of academic qualifications. She founded the Early Childhood Care and Education Council Malaysia in 2010, and the Association for Professional Early Childhood Educators in 2005. She also spearheaded the founding of the National Association for Gifted Children in Malaysia. Dr. Cham was a Human Rights Commissioner of Malaysia during 2000 and 2010. This was followed by her appointment as the first Malaysia representative to the ASEAN Commission on the Foundation and Protection of the Rights of Women and Children. Dr. Cham, as a professor, has authored and written numerous articles and books. And she also sits on the editorial board of very prestigious Malaysian and international journals, including the Malaysian Human Rights Journal, International Journal of Childcare, and education policy, and so on. In recognition of her distinguished services and accomplishments, she was awarded the Juvenile Justice Without Borders International Award by the International Juvenile Justice Observatory for her significant contributions to ECCE. She is also awarded the Malaysian the Citizenship of Humanity by the National Committee on Human Rights Education Australia. And of course, the Hall of Fame, National Science Centre, Women Scientists. And we are extremely proud to have another woman achiever amongst our Miss. Congratulations, Professor.
Thank you, Vice Chancellor Dr. Paul Chan. And can we kindly invite our Chancellor, Dr. Paul Leong, to the right rostrum to read the conferment, please.
As the Chancellor of the University, I have been authorized by the Senate to confer the Doctor of Education honoris causa on you.
Thank you, Dr. Paul Leong, and can I kindly invite you to center stage to confer the award.
Thank you, Chancellor. Can we kindly invite you to be seated? Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to invite Dr. Chiam Heng King to deliver her Honorary Doctor of Education Honoris Causa acceptance speech. Can you please join me in welcoming and congratulating her to the podium?
Yang Berbahagia Datuk Paul Leong Ki Siong Chancellor, Yang Berbahagia Datin Chak Lo Kam Yong, Help University Chief Executive Officer of Help University, Yang Berbahagia Professor Datuk Dr. Paul Chan, Vice Chancellor and President of Help University, distinguished guests from the partner universities, senior management staff, parents, graduates of the class 2023, ladies and gentlemen. I'm very glad that in spite of my fall 2 days ago, I can proudly and yet humbly stand before you to accept this honorary Doctor of Education from this prestigious university. That has played a great part in developing the talents and potential of thousands of students in Malaysia, as well as from other parts of the world since its inception 37 years ago. The acknowledgement of this achievement of Help University is based on numerous awards bestowed upon the university. To name a few, Ford's recognition of Help University as one of the best performing company in Asia Pacific 2011, Brand Laureate Award for Tertiary Education Private 2021 to 2012, designated Primary Digital Tech University, one of the four private university in 2019, and the first university to be awarded the maximum 5-star rating across 9 categories in the QS University in 2020. This achievement firmly established Help University as an internationally firmly established higher education leader driven by the cosmopolitan culture and global curricula. Congratulations to all the new graduates and their parents. Having obtained a good education in this university, you have to get out to the world and apply your knowledge and skills for yourselves and for good and for the good of humanities. This university degree is just the beginning. To succeed and achieve your full potential, you need humility and willingness to learn, the generosity to share your knowledge, diligence and perseverance to share, perseverance to press on, learning from failures, and courage to take on calculated risks to venture into unknowns. 4, creativity and innovations are the way to move forward. Allow me to share an episode in my life to demonstrate the qualities I have just enumerated. Being a social psychologist, the early years of my life as an academician was focused on conducting research on the development of adolescents and their problems, including juvenile delinquency. My research findings indicated experiences in the early years have a profound effect on adolescents' development and behavior. A 10-year cross-sectional and longitudinal study, a joint project of the Faculty of Education and the Faculty of Medicine of the University of Malaya, was conducted to investigate further this finding. This study showed the gap between children from advantaged and disadvantaged backgrounds widened with age in all aspects of development. I was, and I still am, very convinced that the experiences of the first 5 years of a child's life are critical for his or her well-being. Hence, childcare providers and preschool teachers need to be well-trained so that all children, especially those from vulnerable backgrounds, have a good foundation for development to mitigate the number of school dropouts and potential criminals. Many colleagues in the Faculty of Education back then in UM were not in favor of the Faculty of Education offering a degree in early childhood education. Every time I presented the proposal at the faculty meeting, invariably it met with criticisms at least one aspect of the program. It went on for more than 2 years, but I pressed on, as I believe in the importance of this program. Furthermore, neuroscientific studies were beginning to indicate the importance of the first 5 years of a child's life. My struggle ended when Tan Sri Dr. Abdullah Manusa became the Vice Chancellor of UM. He believed in the importance of the early years, and within 6 months, the Bachelor in Early Childhood Education was offered, and that was in 1997, and is the first of its kind in Malaysia. Today, early childhood care and education is acknowledged worldwide to be of critical importance to the well-being of individuals and the nation. I hope this episode demonstrates the qualities a person needs to succeed in life, especially the tenacity to fight for the right cause and believe in one's life. I would like to conclude this acceptance speech by thanking Help University on behalf of the early childhood care and education community. In bestowing this honorary doctorate on me, Help University is acknowledging and promoting the importance of the early years. Hence, this conferment is not only for me alone, but it's also for all the early childhood educators who are out there caring, nurturing, and educating young children so that they have a good foundation to develop. Thank you once again, Help University, for bestowing this honorary degree upon me.
Thank you, Dr. Chiam, and congratulations again. Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, we now move into the event that highlights the accomplishment of all our young people today, the presentation of degrees. We'd like to invite our Chancellor to confer the degrees, please. Can I invite Dr. Paul Leong to the right rostrum to read the conferment? May I request all graduates to please stand.
As the Chancellor of the University, I have been authorized by the Senate to confer degrees on to those who are qualified to receive them.
Thank you, Chancellor. Graduates, please be seated. Can I kindly invite my colleague, Encik Akmal Ayub, head of the Center for General Studies and MPU, to present our graduates to the Vice-Chancellor and to the Chancellor.
Thank you, Mr. Eric Bryan. May I invite Professor Dr. Kong Kim Hung, Deputy Vice Chancellor, Academic, and Ms. Sheena Vajendran, Head, Department of Communication, to present the following degree to the graduates. Professor Kong, I present to you the graduates of the Bachelor of Communication, Marketing Communication with honors. Joel Liu Sung Yang. Lee Long Yi. Lim Jeng Xian. Priyanka Lakshmi, anak perempuan Nalendran. Tan Xiao Sun. The graduates of the Bachelor of Communication Media Studies with honors. Kechavatini, anak perempuan Segar. Muhammad Afiq bin Am Muhammad Fitri. Muizuddin bin Haji Khairul Abasa. Ravina, anak perempuan Raja Ganesan. Putri Aisyah Sufian. Sally Ann Stephen. Vicky Fabrinata Ramadan. The graduates of the Bachelor of Communication, Public Relations with honors. Ami Kikuchi. Chai Da Mu. Hao Zoe. La Hong Ying. Nicole Chiu Xiu Feng. Ong Teng Ho. Lieutenant Tana Laksumi, anak perempuan Mahendiran Raya. Binadaran, anak lelaki Tirunakfu Karasu. Zahra Atira Nirwana. Thank you, Professor Kong and Ms. Sheena. May I now invite Professor Dato' Dr. Paul Chan, Vice Chancellor and President of Help University, and Dr. Gerard Joseph Louis, Pro Vice Chancellor of Help University and Dean, Faculty of Behavioral Sciences, Education and Languages, to present the following degree to the graduates. Professor Chan, I present to you the graduates of the Master of Clinical Psychology. Carmen Lo Ka Moon. Han Yi Men. Hui Yen Ling. Kan Wang On. Lu Chia Yen. Nur Sarafina binti Umar. Tan Hui Yi. The graduates of the Masters in Counseling, Chiam Jo In. Chin Yui Sin. Deborah Yi Koi Yen. Kong Jia Ying. Li Kai Ming. Liu Yong Sin. Ng Jun Kiat. Ng Wan Ling. Sabhan Jamila binti Wan Muhammad Hasni. Selva Kumari, anak perempuan Lor Kusami. Tan So Keng. Wong Yuen Ching. The graduates of the Master of Education, Teaching and Learning. Chua Menzi. Nirmala, anak perempuan Ji Purushoktaman. The graduates of the Bachelor of Early Childhood Education with Honours, Ali Chiu Chai Jun. Caroline Lo Chien Woon. Chong Ya Wen. Chu Ro En. Gan Yi Hui. Jasmine Chua Ching Ling. Jaden Chan Ching Xiang. Jennifer Cheong Kai Men. Joyce Ng Wei Yuan. Camila Prabhae. Kwe Boon Fang. Lee Ka-Wen. Li Shi Wang. Li Yuan Ji. Leong Kai Chi. Lim Tian Yi. Lim Karen. Lo Li Sun. Lu Enzi. Mildred Lo Zi Ying. Nicole Tan. Ong Chi En. Rachel Yap Wai Ching. Sally Wong Yi Wen. Tai Yi Sin. Tan Xiu Yin. Tan Suk Yi. Wong Xiu Lan. Wong Zi Yun. The graduate is a Master of Education teaching English as a second language. Huang Jiaqi. Santa Lakshmi anak perempuan Vangi Kadisan. The graduates of the Bachelor of Education teaching English as a second language with honors. Ms. Chin Li Wei. Chung Jia Wen. Arena Lim Shermin. Hashini Priya anak perempuan Selvanadan. Jonathan Chin Wang Yu. Nivashini anak perempuan Anparasu. Kristina Artini binti Muhammad Nazri. Sanjukta Perumal Sami. San Win En. Vanessa Michelin anak perempuan William Lawrence. Vashini Vijaya Kumar. Wong Lik De. And Yuki Wong Wen Ting. Thank you, Professor Chan and Dr. Gerard Louis. May I now invite Professor Dr. Liu Teck Hui, Deputy Vice Chancellor, Quality and Education Innovation, and Dr. Tang U Liang, Dean, Faculty of Computing and Digital Technology, to present the following degree to the graduates. Professor Liu, I present to you the graduates of the Bachelor of Information Technology with Honours. Chia Chen Yi. Ho Ken Wai Ryan. Katerisen Anak Lelaki Nanda Gopalan. Kenji Yang Ki Chi Yuan. Huan Wei Kiat. Lee Wai Ho. Lim Tian Wei. Man Chai Jun. Ti Sun Ren. Wong Ching Yi. Suhain Anak Lelaki B. Sivabalan. The graduates of the Bachelor of Information Technology with Honours from STICOM Bali. Abijana Agung Ramanda. Cladwin Johannes Pandanga. I. Gedemade Armani Bagus Saputra. I. Made Siva Aditya Surya. Ignas Maula Ibrahim. Lu Wulandari Maharani. The graduate of the Bachelor of Information Technology, Business Information Management with Honours. Ramana Krishna Anak Lelaki Munusami. The graduates of the Bachelor of Information Technology, Data Analytics with Honours. Aidania Binti Effendi. Cho Tiha Nain. Nurliana Amira Binti Khairul Anwar. Thank you, Professor Liu and Dr. Tang. May I now invite Professor Dato' Dr. Zakaria Ahmad, Deputy Vice Chancellor Research, and Ms. Kathleen Nunes, Head Department of Law, to present the following degree to the graduates. Professor Zakaria, I present to you the graduates of the Bachelor of Laws with honors. Aaron Liu. Afiq Norman bin Ibrahim Terry. Arti Kanesan. Daishan Naidu anak lelaki Shanmugam. Gui Jia Yi. Jane Lee Wei. Jonathan Ha Heng Seng. Liu N. E. Melanie Ting Yi Lin. Mio Ghazi bin Mio Khairi. Najma Abu Bakar Muhammad. Sarmila anak perempuan A. Visintiran. Shahira Elisa binti Syamnizal. And Shankari anak perempuan S. Sitarasu. Thank you, Professor Zakaria and Miss Kathleen.
And thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for the conferment of degrees from our Bachelor of Psychological Sciences and Bachelor of Psychology, can I invite my colleague, Dr. Victor Goh, head of the Department of Psychology, to present the graduates.
Thank you, Mr. Eric Bryan. May I invite Professor Dr. Paul Chan, Vice Chancellor and President of HELP University, and Dr. Gerard Joseph Lewis, Pro Vice Chancellor of HELP University, and Dean, Faculty of Behavioral Sciences, Education and Languages, to present the following degree to the graduates. Dr. Gerard Lewis, kindly step to the left side of the stage. Professor Chan, I present to you the graduates of the Bachelor of Psychological Science, Flinders University. Ms. Chin Suan Yu. Mr. Ho Shi Gang. Mr. Joshua Liu Junkit. The graduate of the Bachelor of Psychological Science with Honors, Flinders University, Ms. Wong Yu Sung. Thank you, Professor Chan. May I now invite Professor Dr. Kong Kim Hong, Deputy Vice Chancellor Academic, to present the following degree to the graduates. Professor Kong, I present to you the graduates of the Bachelor of Psychology with Honours. Ms. Agathea Mabel Budiantara. Mr. Ahmed Yazzi Khalil. Ms. Alessandra Rachel Kong Li Xuan. Ms. Alicia Kira Binti Muhammad Yusuf. Miss Amelia Chan Xiang Yi. Miss Amy Vanessa Chai Sin Tong. Miss Ananti Ratnam. Miss Anthea Chin Wenchi. Miss Anusha Anaprampan Sudakaran. Miss Ariel Dominic Huang Shichi. Miss Ayuk Nur Vika. Miss Bong Jin Shen. Mr. Brandon Teo Mingzhen. Mr. Brian Tan Yishen. Miss Catherine Kong Singyin. Miss Catherine Yolanda. Miss Celine Camilla Kaur, Anak Perempuan Bawan Singh. Miss Cha Jing Chun. Mr. Chan Kwok Chi. Miss Chen Ting Sin. Miss Cheryl Santakumari, daughter of Charles Santakumar. Miss Chia Jet Yi. Mr. Chiu Yik Wei. Mr. Chin Chi Yu. Ms. Chin Yi Kei. Mr. Chong Kai Jun. Ms. Chong Yi Sin. Ms. Chong Kari. Ms. Chua Jinling. Ms. Chong Jingyi. Miss Dashwini Anak Perempuan Vijayendran. Mr. Daryl Kurian. Miss Dinusha Anak Perempuan Baskaran. Mr. Edward Lim Sir Z. Mr. Effendi. Miss Ng Lian. Miss Eve Calista Valerie Anak Macklin. Miss Yvonne C. Yuen. Ms. Fatima Rifat Muhammad Rifam. Ms. Fabrina Clarissa Cristono. Ms. Fiona Anak Perempuan Rayapan. Ms. Florence Tan Shi Ying. Ms. Fong Ho Yan. Ms. Fu Shi Qi. Mr. Fu Zhenfeng Raymond. Ms. Fu Zuyi. Mr. Gerald Gan Carlo. Mr. Gilbert Edward Tigo. Mr. Neh P. Swin. And Ms. Go Yen Ting. Thank you, Professor Kong. May I now invite Professor Dr. Liu Teck Kui, Deputy Vice Chancellor, Quality and Education Innovation, to present the degree to the remaining graduates. Professor Liu, I present to you the graduates of the Bachelor of Psychology with Honours. Ms. Heng Ting Wen. Ms. Hugh Wei Ru. Mr. Ian Tham Yik Kuen. Ms. Janice Chan Yi Sien. Ms. Janita Rosario. Mr. Jeremy Ryan Kennedy. Ms. Joey Liu Chin Wei. Ms. Joey Xiao Wei Shan. Ms. Joyce Wu Kasin. Ms. Katrina Divya Anak Perempuan Vincent James. Ms. Kavisha Anak Perempuan Ganalan. Ms. Kirthana Anak Perempuan Gopala Krishna. Ms. Ko Hui Wen. Ms. Ko Sing Jane. Ms. Coit Whiting. Ms. Kok Jia Yin. Mr. Koo Wei Jun. Mr. Lai Zilun. Ms. Lauren Chai Jiachi. Mr. Lawrence Liu Yonghao. Ms. Lee Chiu Ying. Ms. Lee Ivy. Ms. Lee Shu En. Ms. Lee Tian Wei. Mr. Lee Wengzi. Ms. Lee Yongsin. Ms. Leong Yu Lee. Ms. Leong Xin Chi. Ms. Liu Yulin. Ms. Lim Chin Wen. Mr. Lim Chong Lee. Ms. Lim Carmen. Ms. Lim Kersin. Mr. Lim Siu Gin. Ms. Liao Yu Ting. Ms. Lo Yong Jing. Ms. Lau Xiu Xin. Mr. Ma Wei Lun. Ms. Mabel Wong Hui Chi. Ms. Madeline Goh Sin Ying. Ms. Maisara Binti Asmi Sharin. Ms. Maryam Arufa Arif. Ms. Maryam Yana Tholau. Ms. Melanie Thomas. Ms. Michelle Wong Tong Chu. Mr. Mu Wing Han. Ms. Nadia Anissa Churleth. Ms. Natasha Ku Shu Xin. Mr. Ng Han Xiang. Ms. Ng Jeng Ni. Ms. Nga Ji Ern. Ms. Nicole Shim Yi Yi. Ms. Noor Sabrina Binti Kamarudin. Ms. Ong Jia Ying. Ong Serlin. Mr. Ong Wayburn. Ms. Ui Min Suan. Ms. Pang Shuat Yi. Mr. Pavitran Anatlaki Suraj. Ms. Priti Aishwarya Anak Perempuan Jivanadan. Ms. Priscilla Anak Perempuan Santaraj. Ms. Queenie Kaney Lim. Ms. Rafia Natasha Binti Muhammad Sasitaran. Ms. Regina Wong Chi Mei. Ms. Sabila Kairunisa. Ms. Santia Anak Perempuan Marimutu. Ms. Xia Yi Wen. Ms. Shanine Sophie Gunn. Ms. Sharumati Anak Perempuan Subramaniam. Mr. Sean Yap Jen Cheng. Ms. Shalina Mary Windsor. Ms. Charlene Lee Ming Hui. Mr. Sim Chia Ming. Ms. Siti Aloya Binti Awangku Suhaili. Mr. So Ping Zheng. Ms. Song Shuet Yi. Ms. Sri Kugasheni, anak perempuan Mutamil Maram. Ms. Stephanie Gan Yi Lian. Ms. Sujiita, anak perempuan Parimalam. Ms. Shahira binti Muhammad Azhar. Ms. Shakira Putri Rinaldi. Ms. Tan Hui Bien. Ms. Tan Lee Suan. Ms. Tan Pek Kong Alethea. Ms. Tan Shi Ning. Ms. Tan Sok Gye. Ms. Tan Su Yi. Ms. Tan Ji Cheng Jenny. Ms. Tan Zemin. Ms. Tang Zisuan. Ms. Tara Tan Yanxiang. Mr. Tay Zemin. Ms. Teo Jia Hui. Ms. Teo Chin Chun. Ms. Teo Jing Chi. Ms. Terry Wong Ying Chin. Ms. Tarini Anak Perempuan Shamugam. Ms. Tiu Chien Chi. Ms. Tin Lingzi. Mr. Ting Zhao Long. Ms. Teo Kai Ying. Ms. Vanessa Yeo Woon Chen. Mr. Victor Hugh Sin Kai. Ms. Wan Sin Ru. Mr. Wong Kwan Yu. Ms. Wong Sin Yi. Ms. Yang Yi Ting. Mr. Yap Nien Boon. Ms. Yap Shu Tian. Ms. Yap Yu Xian. Ms. Yap Ji Xian. Ms. Yashini Anak Perempuan Krishnan. Mr. Yip Lee Jung Victor. Mr. Zachary Un Wei Chen. And Miss Zoe Ong Si Yi. Thank you, Professor Liu and Dr. Gerard Lewis.
And thank you, Dr. Victor Goh. Our gratitude and thanks to all the presenters. Ladies and gentlemen, we now come to the presentation of awards. We begin with the Tan Sri Dato' Paduka Dr. Hajah Salihah Outstanding Achievement Award. This award is presented to the graduate who has excellent academic achievements, contributed to the extracurricular activities at HELP University, and has shown outstanding leadership qualities. We would like to invite the Chancellor, Dato' Paul Leong, to please come forward to present the award. Ladies and gentlemen, the 2023 Tan Sri Dato' Paduka Dr. Hajah Salihah Outstanding Achievement Award goes to, from the Faculty of Behavioral Sciences, Education and Languages, Department of Psychology, Ms. Nga Ji Eun, First Class Honours, Bachelor of Psychology. Congratulations, Ms. Nga Ji Eun, and thank you, Chancellor. Next, we have the HELP University President's Award. The criteria for this award that it is presented to the graduates with the most outstanding academic achievement at the departmental level. May I invite back to center stage the Chancellor to present the President's Award. Ladies and gentlemen, this year we have three recipients present for the award. From the Faculty of Behavioral Sciences, Education and Languages, Department of Psychology, Ms. Lee Shu Eun, Bachelor of Psychology, First Class Honours. From the Faculty of Communication, Department of Communication, Ms. Nicole Chiu Siu Fung, Bachelor of Communication, Public Relations, First Class Honours. And from the Faculty of Law and Government, Department of Law, Mr. Dashan Naidu Shanmugam, Bachelor of Law, First Class Honours. Thank you, Chancellor, and congratulations again to all our winners. Can we give them a round of applause, please? Dear graduates, representing your graduating class and this year's valedictorian, it gives me great pleasure to introduce to you from the Faculty of Behavioral Sciences, Education and Languages, Department of Psychology, First Class Honours student, and your valedictorian, Ms. Ha Ji Eun.
Thank you, Mr. Eric Bryan, for the incredibly kind introduction. Chancellor Datuk Paul Leong, Vice Chancellor and President Datuk Paul Chan, CEO Datin Chan Lo Kam Yok, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, and especially the graduates, the class of 2023. Good morning. I see a lot of fresh faces up here today. Hello. Congratulations, we made it. I'm honored, moved, grateful, and just a little terrified to be standing in front of y'all today. If the view up here is any indication that we have a lot of names and stories to get through in the next few hours, nope. But I'll do my best to keep my remarks succinct. So over the past few days, I've been asking my friends to reflect on what they've learned and what they're most proud of from their time at HELP University. In part because I think introspection is particularly powerful in such a time of change, but also it's an intimidating task to sum up each of our unique paths through this institution in just a few minutes. So my friends and classmates, they told me some incredibly touching stories. A new friend of mine shared she no longer hesitates to raise questions in a 200-person lecture class. She learned to ask for help as it does not reflect one's weakness, but strength. My foundation friend said that he left his comfort zone to grab opportunities he thought was once unattainable. The soft skills and hard skills that he acquired, now he approached it with confidence. My housemate said she finally found her true self, her identity. She's now comfortable the way she is, and to that friend, what is lost can never be found. What is found can never be forgotten. Another close friend of mine said she learned about staying engaged and committed to our shared value of open-mindedness and empathy across people with diverse backgrounds. She developed the ability to appreciate and leverage differences with diverse backgrounds in order to achieve shared goals. Last but not least, my Tom Yang Gang concluded that they walked in with zero expectations, but walked out with families not by blood. The genuine relationships they get to form throughout this journey, the support system established to their lowest lows and highest highs were nothing but precious. Today is the day to celebrate all of those victories, because that is what they are, as small as they may seem. Sure, they are not as obvious as grades and awards, and all those external markers of value. But in truth, whether it's surviving through an 8 a.m. class or a smoothly run club meeting, we have succeeded in a million different ways during our time here. From the mortar board that we are wearing on our heads to the things that we'll tell our kids 20 years later to prove that we are definitely super cool in college, we carry evidence of our successes with us and with pride. But I also hope that after 3 to 4 years at this institution, we walk away with confidence not just in our victories, but in our failures as well. The not so shiny stuff, the things that we will never put on plaques, hang up on walls, or even wear around our necks. The assignments and quizzes that we bombed, the job applications that ghosted on us, and the emails that we send out stating, please see the attached file, without actually attaching the file. The wows that we didn't make too. While today may be a beautiful, glorious milestone, a cap to 4 years of life and growth, as well as hard work, a celebration of all that has gone right, I hope we can also take the time to celebrate all that went wrong that brought us to this point. Today is not a static moment in time. We are going to wake up tomorrow or next week or next year and be asked to do things that are difficult, awkward, and probably frustrating. The failures that we have encountered here will poise us to the next challenges on. One of the hardest but most valuable things that HELP has taught me is to maintain persistence and positivity in the face of adversity. To keep dreaming big and failing often. To keep doing the things that once scared me and picking myself up even when it feels impossible. I'll be honest with you, I'm not quite done learning this lesson yet. I'm still working on building resilience and cultivating a healthy relationship with failure. While I'm blessed to be selected as the recipient of the Tan Sri Paduka Award and also the valedictorian to represent you today, I also remember the days when my exam paper was returned with only 3 marks. Yeah, 3 marks. I was never the smart kid in school. Oops, that's fine. Someone who never considered themselves as particularly smart or talented in academics or sports, that was a crushing low for me. And it's something that I find it hard to even admit in front of y'all today. I like to reference the work of a psychologist named Carol Dweck, who coined the term the growth mindset. Dweck speaks about 2 different viewpoints that you can have of yourself. First, you can see yourself and your capabilities as static, defined by what you know you can do and what you're born with. Or you can see them as dynamic, always capable of change and thus improvement. To have a growth mindset is to celebrate the process and the effort you put into a journey. The way an experience shapes you regardless of whether the outcome is good or bad. It means taking responsibility for your failures without letting them define you. It means focusing on the process of learning and growing rather than just the end result. It also means apparently talking about your 3 out of 100 marks points in front of literally thousands of people with nothing but pride. We've spent the past few years in an environment very focused on success of the most conventional kind. I hope to challenge you not to just expand your definition. I hope to challenge you to expand your definition of success beyond the big flashy things, but to expand what you believe should be celebrated. I'm not saying that you should list your mistakes on your grad caps or even your Instagram bios, but our mistakes, our failures, our messiness, they all deserve to be honored just as our highlights do. Our past shortcomings reflect real, tangible growth. They reflect movement on our path towards the present and the future. My education journey made me a person hungry for growth, an individual willing to build something from nothing, and far more aware of what I wanted and value as I progressed to the next stage in life. It primed me to take these next scary steps as a much more mature and effective individual. Similarly, your failures, whatever they may be, have brought you here. Your failures now have shaped and formed you into the version of yourself sitting here in your cap and robe. I hope as we celebrate, our successes and failures today, you are nothing but proud of the person you have become at Help University. Before I end my speech today, I ask that we take a moment to show our appreciation for all those who have helped us to get here. Please join me in a round of applause for our families, our lecturers, our friends, and all the people you hold gratitude in heart. Thank you. And once again, congratulations and happy graduation, class of 2023.
Thank you, Gian. Thank you for your stories and your honesty and for inspiring all of us. Actually, she stole a little bit of the thunder earlier, because there's only one last thing before we walk out this hall, my dear graduates. And I would like to request, before we end today, is for you to stand up, turn around, try and locate your parents, your loved ones, your wives, your husbands, and let's honor all of them by giving them a round of applause. So can we stand and just face our parents, our loved ones, and let's give them a round of applause, everyone. Thank you. Can you kindly be seated? Well, my dear friends, we've come to the end of the ceremony. We thank you, graduates. Yes, you are now graduates. We thank you for gracing our halls of learning, and we wish you every success in your future. You are now part of HELP's evolving story and history. May you go forth and be a living testament that we are truly a university of achievers. To all gathered here this morning, we thank you for your presence, for your support. Ladies and gentlemen, can we all kindly stand as the academic procession leaves the hall, and may we invite the Chancellor and Vice Chancellor to lead the academic procession. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, everyone. Let the celebrations begin. Have a great evening today, and congratulations again. Thank you all.
My name is Dr. Nicholas Lam. I'm the Dean of the ELM Graduate School at HELP University. I'm in charge of the ELM Graduate School that have 2 doctorate programs and 9 master's degrees. The directions of ELM Graduate Schools is to focus on the experiential learning that emphasize on innovations and creativity. We want to make learning a fun and memorable experience. The focus of ELM Graduate School for the next few months will be a few key products. The first one is the FLQ Doctorate of Business Administration, and also we have the FLQ Master's Degree programs in 3 different areas. For the FLQ Doctorate programs, learners with 25 years of experience can join us, while for the Master's program, we'll need 20 years of working experience, and you can join us through your relevant working experience. The positioning of the ELM Graduate School will be focusing on the key senior executive market, including leadership positions and senior management in organizations. The reason why we are doing that is because with experiential learning, your experience will be very influenced and important in the whole learning process. And together with this, we can create a very powerful network for all our learners, not only in Malaysia, but throughout the world. So the main attractiveness of the ELM Graduate School is through this experiential learning. I now invite all the learners, not only from Malaysia but throughout the world, come to join the ELM Graduate School's experiential learning platform.
mom, dad, and I. I want to take one of you.